وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
My beloved brothers and sisters, in this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I'm planning to inshallah talk about the virtues and the hidden secrets that are in repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fada'il and the asrar, the virtues and the hidden secrets and gems that you will attain once you come with repentance. Repentance, tawbah, has fada'il jamma, has many virtues. And it also has wa asrar badi'a, hidden secrets that are truly magnificent only if a person truly comes to understand it. And there is many virtues and benefits that you reap from repentance. There are also blessings, barakat muta'addida, that you will attain from repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to mention five, even though I've gathered over 58, but I'm only going to mention five inshallah ta'ala in this episode bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. The first one is أن التوبة سبب الفلاح والفوز بسعادة الدارين. That the repentance is the means to success. It is the path and the road to success. It is also the path to being triumph, the path to being glorious in this world and in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that in the Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. All of you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, turn back to Him, ask Him for forgiveness, He will give you success. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the upper hand. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so you can attain. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ أَيْ لِكَيْ تُفْلِحُونَ لِكَيْ تُفْلِحُوا, so you can attain success. So you can attain success and prosperity. So the first thing that we realize from repenting to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, Allah makes us victorious. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us success in this world and in the hereafter. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said something very powerful. Ibn Taymiyyah said, فالقلب لا يصلح ولا يفلح ولا يتلذذ ولا يسر ولا يطيب ولا يسكن ولا يطمئن. He said that the heart does not become successful. It doesn't become upright. It doesn't taste. It doesn't enjoy itself. It doesn't find happiness. It doesn't find tranquility. إِلَّا بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ وَحُبِّهِ وَالْإِنَابَةِ إِلَيْهِ, except in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also in the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also in the repentance of Allah. And in the heart, when it is stripped from repentance and you do not repent, your heart will lose tranquility. It starts to become unstable. You start becoming, as we call today, stress. Become very stressful. You feel very low. If it grows even more, that feeling, it could lead to suicidal thoughts. And all of it is because lack of ibadah, lack of lovers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, lack of repentance. And wallahi, this kalam of Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, it's a reality that many of us have already seen. And we've already felt it. That whenever you see yourself in a particular state where you feel low, you feel unhappy, you feel at unease, remember your relationship with Allah has become weak. Your bond with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has become weak. You haven't turned back to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And that's what your heart is feeling at this moment. That's why you don't have salah and falah and taladdud. You can't taste the joy of the things that you have. And maybe that person is a rich person, he's got so much money, he's got everything, he's got health, and he's got everything. وَلَا يَتَلَذَّذْ. He can't enjoy what he has. Why are you unable to enjoy the wealth that you have? Why are you not feeling the health that you have? Why are you not, you got family? Why are you not seeing the family and the people around you? Why is that all taken away from you, that feeling? It's because the heart has lost ibadah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it has lost the love of Allah, or it's reduced in the heart, or the turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second benefit, the second virtue that is in repentance is tukaffaru sayyi'at. Repentance expiates your sins. Once you repent, your sins are expiated. They are cleaned off the record. And it's like you've never done it before. At-ta'ibu min al-dhanbi kaman la dhanba lahu. The one who repents is like he's never ever done that sin. That's what repentance does for you. And all of the sins that you've done and you've repented from, it's like you never ever done it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Qur'an, يَا أَيُّوَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا عَسَى رَبُّكُمْ أَن يُكَفِّرَ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ وَيُدْخِلَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. In this ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us, he called us out. He said to us, يَا أَيُّوَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, who have iman in your hearts, تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا. Come with tawbatun nasuha. I will speak about that inshallah ta'ala. Asa rabbukum an yukaffir ankum sayyi'atikum. Allah will expiate for you all your sins, your mistakes, your errors, what you've said, what you've done, what you've missed out on. All of that will be forgiven for you. And that's the second benefit for repentance. All of the sins that you have done and you've repented for, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will clear it off the record for you. Number three, the third benefit and virtue and also barakah that repentance has in it is تُبَدَّلُ السَّيِّئَاتِ الْحَسَنَاتِ. تُبَدَّلُ السَّيِّئَاتِ حَسَنَاتِ. The wrong that you have done, the evil that you've done, by repenting, it will be exchanged to good. Imagine that. And if the evil you were doing, the crimes that you committed, that you thought were a lot, and you, subhanAllah, I've done so much sins, if you repent, those sins will be turned into righteous deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِ حَسَنَاتٍ. Pay attention here. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ, those who repented, وَآمَنَ, second thing, they believed in Allah. Third is what? وَعَمِلَ, and they did عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, righteous actions. Three things. Tawbah, Iman, and عَمَلْ صَالِحًا. What does Allah do for them? فَأُولَيْكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. All of the wrong that they did, all the mistakes that they came with, all the shortcomings, all the crimes, all the transgressions, all evil doings, all of it will be changed into good for them. وَلِذَلِكَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ بْنَ عَبَّاسٍ said something very powerful. He said, مَا رَأَيْتُ النَّبِيَّ. Abdullah ibn Abbas said, I never saw the Prophet. Fariha. I never saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ma ra'aytu an-nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fariha bi shay'in. I never saw the Prophet ever become happy with something. Farahahu bi hadhihi al-ayah, when this ayah came down. Illa man taba wa amana wa 'amila 'amalan salihan fa ulaika yubaddilullahu sayyi'atihim hasanat. Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, I never saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam become happy the way that he became happy that day when that verse came down. لَمَّا أُنزِلَتْ وَفَرَحُوا بِنُزُولِ إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا لِيَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. And in also the other ayah, he said, the Surah Al-Fath, where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. When that came down, the way that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became happy for those two verses, Abdullah ibn Abbas, and he said, I never saw the Prophet become happy like that for anything. The fourth benefit, virtue that is in repentance is أن التوبة سبب للمتاع الحسن ونزول الأمطار وزيادة القوة والإمداد بالأموال والبنين. Repentance is a reason for a good life. By repenting, you will attain a good life. You will have a good life. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will send down rain from you, from the sky. Yani Allah will give you provision, rizq, your rizq. Wa nuzulul amtar means rain will come down from the sky to this earth. Then it will fertilize your crops on the earth. And then the vegetations will all come. You will harvest them. Allah will do all of that for you. وَزِيَادَةِ الْقُوَّةِ Allah will give you strength, power. وَالْإِمْدَادِ بِالْأَمْوَالِ Allah will aid you and support you with wealth. وَالْبَنِينَ With children. All of that is what my brothers and sisters is through repentance. That's what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said in the ayah, وَأَنِسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ يُمَتِّعْكُمْ مَتَاعًا حَسَنًا إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى وَيُؤْتِ كُلَّ ذِي فَضْلٍ فَضْلَهُ Ponder there. وَأَنِسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ Repent your Lord. ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ And then repent to Him. يُمَتِّعْكُمْ مَتَاعًا حَسَنًا Allah will give you a good life. This dunya, you're going to have a very good life. But it's after you repent from your sins and your shortcomings. وَيَزِيدُكُمْ In another ayah, we're going to come to it. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, وَيَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ عَلَى لِسَانِ نَبِيِّ اللَّهِ هُود Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, وَيَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيَزِيدُكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَى قُوَّتِكُمْ وَلَا تَتَوَلَّوْا مُجْرِمِينَ Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us in this ayah, نَبِيِّ اللَّهِ هُود saying to His people, وَيَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ My people, repent to Allah, turn back to Allah, ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala for forgiveness. ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ And repent to Him. يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيَزِيدُكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَىٰ قُوَّتِكُمْ Allah will send rain down from the sky for you. And Allah will strengthen you and give you power. وَلَا تَتَوَلَّوْا مُجْرِمِينَ Don't turn away as criminals and reject the repentance that's been given to you. Nabi Allah Nuh said the same thing to his people. Nabi Allah Nuh also said the same. He said, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا I said to them, turn back to your Lord. Ask for forgiveness from your Lord. إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one that will forgive and expiate for you your mistakes. What will happen? If they do that and they ask Allah for forgiveness and they repent, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send down from the sky rain for them. He will provide for them. He will take care of their needs. But they have to come with the repentance. He's forgiving subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fifth is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who repent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in the Qur'an, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves those who repent. He loves the slaves that are conscious of their own actions and what they've done and said. And they turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they ask Allah for forgiveness. Allah loves that subhanahu wa ta'ala. He loves a slave that keeps repenting and repenting and repenting and repenting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves that. Rather, it makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy. It actually makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala laugh. At the slave when he repents. ولذلك the Prophet told us in the hadith in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, Allah is more happier than a slave. Allah is more happier for a person to repent than a slave was in a desert. The Prophet gave us an example here. A slave who's in the desert, and he places his whole entire provision on his riding beast, his camel. And then what he does is that he puts his food, his rizq, everything he owns is on that riding beast. And he's in the middle of the desert. No one is there to help him. No, he's by himself and his riding beast. His whole entire provision is on there. And guess what happens? His provision gets lost. His riding beast gets lost. He can't find it. He doesn't know where it is. And then he gets ready for death. He prepares himself for death. And guess what? He gave up. And then as he is lying under a tree, his riding beast is right on top of him. He sees it. He finds his riding beast. How will that slave feel at that moment when he finds his riding beast? What kind of joy will that slave feel? Happiness. That happiness that that slave feels at that moment is not even close to the happiness Allah feels when a slave repents to him. That's what the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam. So what I say to brothers and sisters is you're taking away from Allah something that makes him happy. The repentance that makes Allah happy, you're not bringing it, you're not coming with it. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgives us for our shortcomings, our major and minor mistakes, anything that we have said or done privately and publicly, that Allah forgives us for it. Oh Allah, we are your slaves. We have wronged, we have committed crimes. Oh Allah, forgive us. Oh Allah, forgive us. And I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He forgives us for the shortcomings and the mistakes and the errors I have come with while speaking. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illallah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.